Krasukha Electronic Warfare Complex was developed by the Novgorod Scientific and Production Association Kvant, which is part of KRET concern. Krasukha-S4 consists of two vehicles on a four-axle KAMAZ chassis. All-terrain vehicles carry a wide range of equipment, antennas, radio stations, satellite navigation systems, power amplifiers, data transmission equipment. The Krasukha improves the capabilities of air defense and electronic warfare systems against high-precision weapons. The complex protects command posts, air defense positions and areas of concentration of troops from enemy radars. This system is capable of disabling satellite navigation, communications networks, early warning aircraft and ground-based radars up to a distance of 300 kilometers. Accordingly, it can cover areas up to 600 kilometers. It is mobile and can operate at temperatures ranging from minus 50 to plus 50 degrees Celsius. It can distinguish between enemy and friendly signals in its area of operations. The Krasukha complex creates powerful interference at all frequencies used by radars and other specialized radio-emitting systems and facilities. The speed and the altitude of the enemy aircraft does not affect its performance. The complex is able to detect, track and do jamming in automatic mode. The performance characteristics of the Krasukha-S4 complex make it possible to detect and track all types of air targets, including those moving at low altitude. The antenna mast devices of the complex are capable of operating in any direction and rise at any angle, which makes it possible to transmit a radio signal without restrictions in azimuth and elevation. All enemy aircraft in one way or another maintain contact with control centers. The work of electronic warfare equipment is aimed at interrupting these channels, jamming the signals. Aircraft equipment is temporarily disabled, control is disrupted, the ability to use reconnaissance equipment and strike weapons is disrupted. Vladimir Artyakov, first Deputy General Director of the Rostec State Corporation, spoke about the effectiveness of Russian electronic warfare systems. "This is what our system is set up against. It is impossible to control drones when we turn on the electronic warfare system. They become uncontrollable and fall down without fulfilling their main combat mission. Krasukha-S4 is of particular importance for combating low-flying targets, helicopters, attack aircraft, and some types of UAVs. Flying at low altitude is necessary to reduce the likelihood of detection by air defense systems. Both sides use this tactic. After exposure to the jamming by the complex, a low-flying airborne aircraft is forced to increase altitude in order to improve the signal, and comes under attack by anti-aircraft systems. Russia has learned how to disable the Excalibur artillery projectile and JDAMER guided bombs. The high-precision Excalibur projectiles used by Ukraine, aimed at the target using a GPS signal, have ceased to hit targets. Secret Pentagon documents published online have shown that 4 out of 9 JDAMER bombs may have missed their target due to the Russian military jamming the GPS signal. Missiles launched by American HIMARS are also increasingly missing the target. With the help of electronic warfare, the Russian military has also learned how to disable a large number of Ukrainian drones. Sometimes the armed forces of Ukraine lose up to 10,000 UAVs a month. Most drones are lost when the GPS signal is interrupted.